All right, ladies and gentlemen. You know the stakes in this match. You know what it is. Danny V5 is set to go one-on-one with Dagon in a match that could change the future of his entire life. He has his family in the crowd, Hachi V5 and his wife. And if this match goes sour for Danny V5, their lives could be changed for the worse. Because if Danny V5 loses here tonight, he has to join Apocrypha. And we've seen what's happened to men that have joined Apocrypha. We've seen what's happened to Big Bobby Smalls, the Griffin Zinda, the monsters that they've turned into, the psychological damage that has been done to their lives and everyone around them, how they've been alienated. We're going to see here tonight if Danny V5 is able to stand up to Dagon, if he is able to stop Dagon in his tracks here tonight, if he is able to do what is right and put an end to Apocrypha once and for all, or if Dagon is able to take Danny V5 and turn him into his little plaything in Apocrypha. This is such a gigantic match for Danny V5, for his family, for everyone around him. And for Dagon, this is just a match of vanity. This is all for his ego. He is wrestling this match just to get Danny V5 under his influence. And now here comes the man that may change Danny V5's life forever. That man has broken individuals. He has taken lives and turned them upside down. He is an evil, sadistic, sick son of a bitch. And here tonight, he is looking to do to Danny V5 what he has done to many individuals in the past. And if he does it to Danny V5, I don't know that his influence will ever stop spreading. And now, this match is underway. Danny V5 and Dagon. And now out of the ring goes Dagon. What is happening here? It's so much on the line. Dagon is doing that, and oh man! V5 already putting life and limb on the line, and Dagon just outsmarting him. Taking advantage of the emotion of this match of Danny V5. Dagon is absolutely brilliant. You have to hand it to him. And he is taking down Danny from the very start of this match. And oh man, that is the power of Dagon. He was very underrated, but he has it. Danny not going to go down that easily, though. Oh! Back body drop from Dagon. And now into another cover. One. Two, but Danny again, kicking out. Jesus Christ, Dagon. Just kicking him down there. Now he's got him against the ropes. And my God, he's just biting Danny V5. Maybe trying to bite away the pieces of that mask and now floating into a cover here. V5! This time it's a two count. Dagon keeping him down just a little bit longer every time, and now he's just beating the hell out of V5. Sends him off the ropes here, and oh my God, he connected with that huge running knee. We've seen that multiple times from Dagon. It's put away many of opponents, one, and Danny V5 out at one. But hold on a second, now Danny fighting back, big drop kick, takes down Dagon. And now V5 firing away, big spin kick, and now he's got him in the corner, picking away. All the emotion, all the fury, Danny V5 is fired up for this match here tonight in a crucifix. Can he put Dagon away like this? One, two, oh no. Dagon gets out, and out of the ring goes. And that is the intelligence of Dagon. In the ring, Dagon is nearly perfect. He rarely, if ever, makes a mistake. Danny is going to have to replicate a performance like that, and look at this. This may be a mistake right here. Danny V5 chasing Dagon. And look at that, the STO from Dagon into a quick cover, looking to finish this thing here. Two, and oh! Danny V5 barely gets that shoulder up. Dagon was almost able to trick Danny V5 and take him into Apocrypha. And oh my God, he's got him in a camel clutch, using that mask as leverage there. Jesus Christ. This is a brutal maneuver from Dagon, using everything, including V5's mask, but oh my. Danny, nice counter. The veteran, and now look at that, a reverse bulldog. That isn't something you see every day. Into the cover, one, and Dagon out at one. Oh, but look at that. And that is the technical prowess of Dagon. A perfect arm drag. And now look at this, the Uranagi. And Danny V5 is in trouble. At every turn, it's been Dagon. Every single aspect of this match has been Dagon. And I don't know if it's nerves. I don't know if it's stress over the situation. But Dagon is playing Danny V5 here at every single turn in this match, and now kicking away at that back. Oh God! A brutal kick to V5. And now Dagon looking for a weapon. There are no disqualifications here, and hold on, oh my God. Danny V5's got the steel chair, and he set it down. Oh no. Oh my God! Dagon was just walloped with that chair, and now Danny into the cover. Oh, and Dagon out at two. My God, that was a hell of a chair shot from V5, putting everything into it for all the torment. Dagon's put him through in a big DDT. Now Danny's got that chair. You can feel the emotion in every swing Danny takes, and look at this. Big DDT onto that chair. And now V5 to the second rope. Jumping nearly halfway across the ring for that senton bomb. And now he's got that chair. Preparing to swing it, and oh my God. No way. He's got the neck of Dagon. Lodging that chair, no. Dagon, Dagon broke free, no. Oh my God. And now he's got Danny up top. Danny has to get out of this. Oh my God, he's got him in position. A fallaway slam from the top. Dagon threw Danny V5 all the way across the ring. And Jesus Christ. Dagon. Smashing into V5 in the corner. That may have been Danny's best shot. Now look at this. Oh God, Dagon using the ropes. And oh! Caught him with the knee into the cover. This could do it. One, two, and oh! Danny barely able to roll that shoulder up. That's the second time in the match that he was nearly put away.
Dagon is coming very, very close to finishing V5, but Danny gonna keep fighting. He's got him on the ropes. And now sending him off. Japanese arm drag, perfectly executed from Danny V5. That is vintage. We have seen that so many times over the years. Look at that beautiful maneuver from Danny. And now lifting him to his feet. Oh, he sent him to the outside. And oh my God, Danny V5, the shots to the back. Backstabber from V5 into the cover. That may do it for Dagon. One, two, but no. Dagon staying alive. And you gotta know this is getting into the head of Danny V5, just like everything else Dagon has done. A master manipulator is Dagon, and now he's sent V5 off the ropes. And oh my God, that spine buster onto the chair. Danny V5 is in serious trouble now. We've seen him fight back from it in this match already and multiple times over his career, but no! Oh my God! That may be it! The Uranage onto the chair, what force! Two, but no, again! V5 just barely rolling that shoulder off the mat. And now he caught him with the running knee! Dagon may have just put this match away. But oh my God. He is not done with Danny V5. Oh, he went for that running knee again. Danny got out of the way momentarily. Clothesline. Danny stayed on his feet. But another clothesline. He had to go down. Danny V5 is one tough SOB. He is not inhuman. Two when he rolls the shoulders up again. And that big kick to the back from Dagon. Oh my God, and again. Dagon has taken Danny V5 to his world. Oh my goodness. Look at this. V5 escaped the ring and went right at him, but Dagon caught him with a shot to the head. Danny V5 finally punching back. And all the rebel yell for V5. Paying homage to his tag team partner for a long time. Into the cover. Two. No. And now Dagon just barely rolling that shoulder up. And look at this. Even more tribute to his rebel partner, Warren Marshall, and you gotta love this. Danny V5 doing everything that he knows how to do, everything in his arsenal to try to put away Dagon. And now, he is sending him to the top rope. Oh man, what is he looking for? Oh my God, he's got him up. V-cutter from the top! V-cutter from the top! And now turning him over into the cover. This has got to do it. I've never seen anybody kick out of this. Two! But Dagon just barely rolling that shoulder up. Right at the edge of the two count. My God! But now Dagon catching the kick in one hell of a clothesline. I have no idea how Dagon is still even awake after that V-cutter, and my God, there you see the strength of Dagon. I remarked about it earlier in the match. There it is on full display. And now, back body drop yet again. My God, that forearm, and Danny tried to stay up after the forearms, just couldn't do it. This is Dagon's world, and this world is one of torture and pain. As evidenced by that Uranage. And I think it may be smart for Danny to stay down here. Oh no. Able to kick out at two, and my God, Dagon is ripping apart the back of Danny V5. Just laughing in his face now. How much lower can you get? And oh my God, V5 tried to retaliate, but this may be it. No, Suicide Solution. Wait a second! Danny V5! What a counter! What a counter! What a counter! Turn it into a Hurricane Rana, and now he's got him up! Blue Thunder Bomb! Danny V5 has just turned this match around completely! And now he's got him! Oh my god! Emerald Fusion from V5! That was his finisher for a long time! That's not even enough for Dagon, and he knows it! He's got him up again! The second Emerald Fusion! My god! He's got him up for a third time! Oh Jesus Christ, he's got him right on that chair! Emerald Fusion on the chair! Jesus Christ! Dagon may be out! And Danny V5 calling him to his feet! Could this be it for Dagon? V-Cutter! My god, he's not even done there! V-Cutter! Can even Dagon outlast this? V5 has put himself through hell to get to this position. He is trying his damnedest to get into the cover. Drapes his arm over. 1, 2. And Dagon gets the shoulder up. How in the hell did he do that? I have no earthly idea. He outlasted 3 Emerald Fusions. 1 directly on top of the chair. 2 V-Cutters. And now, able to roll out of the way of the clothesline and the STO. Dagon is inhuman. I have no idea how he has lasted this long. Danny V5 put him through hell, and now he's looking for a sleeper hold. He is trying to submit Danny V5 here, or at least choke him unconscious. Danny is in a heap of trouble right now. If he can't get out of this choke, he's trying. He escaped the guard, and now look at that. Able to roll out. Great way to get out of that submission hold. And now he's got him. Oh my god! What an innovative move from Danny V5. Now sending him off those ropes. But oh my goodness, big counter from Dagon. Got him with that arm whip and another STO. Dagon has got that move working in this match. Very effective that STO has been. And now, Dagon's got V5 set up here. I have no idea what for. Ascending to the top rope. And he's looking to dive. V-Cutter! And he caught him on the chair! V-Cutter, he caught him on the chair! This has got to do it! This has got to do it! 1, 2, no! Dagon staying alive at 2. My god! What is it going to take to put either of these men away? Danny going to the outside. He is frustrated. He is kicking away at that apron. He knows how much this means. And he's back in the ring now. Not going to lose his composure, but Dagon, he gave him too much time. He gave him too much time. That may be his downfall. He got caught with the Uranagi. No, this can't be. The frustration on the face of Danny V5 as he went to the outside. Just going after that barricade, going to town, a few seconds at max, and that may do it for his career, for his life. No! No! Suicide Solution on the chair, kick out Danny, come on! No! And Dagon is your winner. And Danny V5 is in Apocrypha.
After the match, everybody please mute your mics. After the match, Danny V5 skin immediately starts to go paler and paler until he is almost matching that of Dagon's and that of the rest of Apocrypha. His vision is getting blurry. He's desperately trying to stay awake. He's desperately trying to stay alive. Thousands of people are in the stands, weeping, crying, emotionally distraught, completely and utterly distressed. 80,000 people in shock, horror, and depression. But Danny V5 does not see any of that. Danny V5 only sees 3 people. He only sees his loving wife, his beautiful daughter, and Dagon staring at him. And suddenly, everything's going darker, and the vision of his family is fading, as he can only see Dagon. But with one last desperate look, he glances over at Hachi, and her eyes are pleading at him, begging him to fight, begging him to stay. For 1 second, their eyes lock, and Danny B5 sees hope. His skin starts to get just a little bit darker. He starts to fight it, but then his eyes roll into the back of the head, and Apocrypha completely takes over his body, and Danny starts to speak emotionlessly. Now I lay me down to sleep. I pray Dagon my soul to keep. And if I should die before I wake, I pray Dagon my soul to take. Danny V5 then immediately falls onto the ground, dead. End promo.